Hey guys, how's it going? Hope all is well. My name is Arshawn Carter, and welcome back to another video. Now, today is October 24th, and you may ask, what's the significance of today? Today is the day that my favorite rapper was born, also known as Drake. And just wanted to make a video for him, showing my experience, my appreciation, what he means to me, you know, not only as a fan, but just as a person, you know, his lyrics and songs and albums has really gotten me through tough times and continually does so. And therefore, I just wanted to make a little video showing my appreciation for him. Now, as far as I've been not only just a hip hop fan, but a music fan in general, Drake has always been in the forefront of my favorite artists. Like, yes, he's my favorite rapper of all time, but just as artist wise, he's up there as well. Like The Weeknd is my favorite artist of all time, and him and Drake are like 1A and 1B for me. And the Drake, you know, he's just, I feel like, you know, the numbers, he has it, the stats say he's the best, but he still gets a lot of hate and just a lot of undeserved, bashing on his behalf. And I feel like what he's done for music, you know, goes without saying, you know, it can't be denied. Just the records that he's broken, how high he set the bar for any other rapper that came after him. And heck, even at rappers that came out before him, you know, was trying to keep up. But I feel like Drake's rise to stardom was just like that, you know. I want to say he started taking off around like 2010, maybe around then, maybe a little sooner. Best I Ever Had was like my first real introduction to him, and I'm sure to a lot of you guys too. You know, that song was his breaking out hit. You know, directed by Kanye West, the video. So he was getting a lot of buzz around that time. And then he obviously released Thank Me Later. And then, you know, collabed with Wayne and Young Money. So he was making a name for himself, you know, since from the get-go. And he's only gone up from there. You know, he's released Take Care, which is right here. A classic, top three Drake album. And it's aged so well. You know, just looking at the track list, just Headlines, Crew Love, Take Care, Marvin's Room, Underground Kings, Cameras, Doing It Wrong, The Real Her, which is, I think, is a really, really underrated Drake song, one of my personal favorites, and Look What You've Done, Hell Yeah, Fucking Right, like Practice, The Ride, like this album is just flooded with bangers, start to finish, and it's a classic, and it's the one that you can listen to 10 years down the line, and it'll never, you know, go out of style. And then from then on, he Nothing Was the Same, you know, which I unfortunately don't have the vinyl for yet, at least, which I think is his best album, most cohesive, most entertaining, most personal album as well. I feel like Drake was really getting into what he was going through at the time, you know, trying to adjust to his new lifestyle, you know, him being one of the most famous people on earth. You know, it's going to change a person, but he was just trying to, you know, going through the motions and explaining to us, you know, what he's been going through. And that album is just so great. Just off the top of my head, you know, you got Tuscan Leather, which is probably his best intro. You got Furthest Thing, which I think is one of his best songs. You have, what else on the album? Started From the Bottom, which was the anthem when it came out. You know, you have Too Much, you know, with that Sampha feature, which is a heart-wrenching song, and it's a very powerful song. You got like I said, I'm just thinking at the top of my head, I probably shouldn't do that. Let me see. Oh, you have you also have Wu-Tang Forever, very underrated song. You have Worst Behavior, dope production. From Time, which is one of his best, with Jhené Aiko in there. Hold On, We're Going Home. I don't know how I didn't think of that one. So that's another one of my personal favorite Drake songs. Pound Cake, you know, one of the best beats probably ever in hip hop. Come Through. And then, you know, you got All Me as a bonus track with two killer verses or features from Big Sean and 2 Chainz. So Nothing Was the Same is definitely up there in terms of his best. You also got If You're Reading This, which is was a surprise drop. And that really, Drake around that time was like, no one could really touch him. When he came out with If You're Reading This, that man would just, he broke the internet with that, because it was a surprise drop, like I said, and no one was expecting it. And when it dropped, it was just nothing but banger after banger. with a few softies sprinkled in, like Jungle, which is my favorite Drake song of all time. But just looking through the track list, again, another album I wish I had the vinyl for. Legend, another one of his best intros. Energy, just gets you going, you know, it's very hype and energetic, no pun intended. 10 Bands, it's a banger. Know Yourself, one of his best songs. No Telling, Madonna. I can name every song on this, you know. Wednesday Night Interlude, which isn't technically his song, it's Party Next Door on basically all of it, but it's a sleeper in there. 6 p.m. in New York, him just rapping his ass off. Company with Travis Scott, you know, before he was who he is now, which is a very underrated song. Six Man, but yeah, Jungle, that's my favorite Drake song in general. Just something about that song. It was so different from the rest of the album, which I think is why it's so special. But also it's just the emotion that it brings to you is like second to none. Just makes you feel like a certain way. It's the perfect song to throw on a rainy day, stuff like that. And then from then on, you know, he had, I believe it was More Life after that. Yeah, More Life. You know, Passion Fruit, Free Smoke, another one of his best intros. Gilchester, Portland, Sacrifices, Nothing's Into Somethings, Teenage Fever, Lose You, Fake Love, Ice Melts, Do Not Disturb. There's a lot of great Drake songs on this track list. You know, More Life is one of those albums where you can ask two people and you'll probably get two different answers in terms of whether they liked it or not. Me personally, I got enjoyment out of it. It's a playlist album, you know, was Drake intending for. So it's kind of like you just take songs and leave the rest, you know, just take what sticks and leave what doesn't. But it's a very underrated Drake song, or album, excuse me, I would say. After that, what was it? Scorpion, another one of his albums that kind of is like a really hit or miss when people ask about it. Some people say it sucks. Some people say it gets hate for no reason. Me, I think that it is a good album. You know, it's pretty bloated, 25 songs on it, but I took a lot of these songs out of here. Survival, Nonstop, Emotionless, Six, God's Plan, 8 out of 10, Mob Ties, Can't Take a Joke. You know, just to name a few, you know, I don't want to go on the whole track list, but even on the double side, because this album was a double-sided album, you know, like on a vinyl. You play one side's one album, you turn it to the other side, it's another album. And the first half is rapping, the second half was an R&B cut. So on the R&B side, you know, he has Summer Games, Jaded, Peak, Nice for What, Finesse, In My Feelings, Don't Matter to Me, After Dark, Final Fantasy, March 14th. Like, he's definitely in his bag in this album, you know. I just think what people was concerned about, oh, they wanted it to be like a full rap album, and also it was too many tracks. But me personally, I liked it. Doesn't really get much complaint out of me. Then we also got the album that's had a lot of talk to it, which is Certified Lover Boy. I'm sorry, I don't know why I was blanking on the name. Certified Lover Boy. And when this album dropped, no one was giving it the time of day. I mean, don't get me wrong, there's a few, me included. I didn't see what the hate and the fuss was with this album when it dropped. I guess people, again, was expecting a full rap album, which Drake never had put that out saying he was going to do it. So I don't know. People were just getting mad for no reason. But this album is another long one, 21 songs. But again, I took a lot of songs out of it. Champagne Poetry, one of his best intros in a while. Poppy's Home, Girls Want Girls. People hate that song, but I find it all right. In the Bible, Love All, Fair Trade, Way Too Sexy. That song's not it. I'm not going to lie. Song's not good. TSU, In Too Deep, Pipe Down, No Friends in the Industry, like 7 a.m. on Bridal Path, Race My Mind. Like, again, I can name every song in this track list, and you know, it wouldn't do it justice. You know, it still doesn't get the credit it deserves. I think it's aged well too, from when it first dropped. Like I said, people were just writing it off, and it's a very polarizing album, you know. But I like I said, I find enjoyment with it. And then he dropped Honestly Nevermind in the summer. And that's another album that I really liked. Ever since it came out, I've at least played one or two songs a day from it. And my favorites being like Liability, Jimmy Cooks, Downhill. It's a lot of good songs on it. It dropped the day after the Warriors won the championship. So kind of has like this warm, fuzzy feeling with me. And it was just a good time when this album dropped. And it stuck with me through the summer and after, even till this day. And for future summers and days to come, like I said, I just think it was a good album. You know, it was his attempt at a dance album, And I think it was just that, with also some R&B cuts with Jimmy Cooks, you know, leading up to the Drake album that we're getting next week, you know, with 21 Savage, which I'm super stoked for it. But yeah, just to not lose focus on what this video is about, it's just me showing appreciation to Drake, you know, giving him his flowers. Something else people don't really mention is just the whole brand of Drake, you know, OVO. The fact that he, don't get me wrong, The Weeknd definitely probably would have found his way without Drake. But in the beginning, Drake was, you know, kind of putting The Weeknd's name out there, posting him on his website, Twitter, you know, shouting him out. Like, the Drake did play a big role in The Weeknd, you know, kind of getting to where he's at faster, I guess you could say. But like I said, The Weeknd, he would have made his way out regardless. But the fact that Drake helped him out around that time, you know, like I said, makes me respect him even more. He's also put on guys like Party Next Door, who's also one of my favorite artists too. Division, Maheed Jordan, a few misses like I Love McConan and stuff like that. But Drake, you know, he's always found a way to, you know, just continue to build his brand. And he's also just versatile in terms of trying to expand his music. Like, he'll go to the London and try out drill beats. He'll go to Africa and try Afro beats. Like, you know what I mean? It's like he doesn't box himself into one category, you know. And he also, people like to call him a culture vulture. I don't see that at all. I just see him drawing inspiration from other people and places and putting that to his own music and style. And that's something he's always been untouched with. There's not really any other people that's as diverse as him when it comes to that. And yeah, like Drake, he could rap, he could sing, and he's just one of the best. You know, I'm not trying to sit up here, act like a fanboy. Like I said, I'm just giving him his flowers, because a lot of people don't like to. But yeah, October 24th, happy birthday to the GOAT, in my opinion. And yeah, that's the end of today's video. Appreciate you guys if you guys watched it fully. Like, subscribe, and see you guys till next time. Peace.